This might come as a surprise to some, but is true. The largest city by population in the entire continent of South America is home to a large impact crater which is hidden in plain sight. Do you see it? To make this geologically fascinating feature easier to spot, I have temporarily exaggerated the actual elevation of all regional landforms by a factor of 3. The feature in question is located just on the outskirts of Sao Paulo's broader metropolitan area, specifically 35 kilometers south-southwest of its city center. There, a broad circular depression in the ground can be seen that includes and borders south of the town of Colonia. It is from this that the feature gets its name, being known as Colonia Crater. This impact structure measures a whopping 3,650 meters or 11,975 feet wide and has a rim that rises above the surrounding landscape by as much as 80 meters or 262 feet. A little over 23,000 people live within the boundary of Colonia Crater, largely on erosional infill deposited after long periods of weathering within the impact structure. Because of the size of Colonia Crater, that being in the range of 2 to 4 kilometers wide, it could theoretically be either a simple impact crater with a simple bowl shape or a complex impact crater with a raised central peak in the crater's center. Well, after multiple scientific studies, the results are in. Colonia Crater is a simple impact crater, and surprisingly, its crater bottom, marking the original extent of excavation, is only 275 meters or 902 feet deep. This is a bit of a surprise, as generally speaking, for simple impact craters on Earth, the ratio of the crater diameter to depth is generally about 5.65 to 1. With that in mind, you'd expect Colonia Crater to be far deeper than it actually is, specifically around 646 meters deep. And yet, the actual figure is 3/10 of this. To explain this abnormality, there are a few possibilities to consider. The first factor to note is that unlike some similarly sized pristine impact structures such as Wolf Creek Crater in Western Australia and Meteor Crater in Arizona, the impacting body did not strike a sedimentary rock unit. Instead, Colonia Crater formed in a harder surrounding metamorphic rock type specifically, which is around 650 million years old, known as schist. Thus, less schist will be excavated downwards than sandstone from the same impact event. When I looked at the reports of iron-rich microspherules being found within Colonia Crater, it seemed to me like the best fit for the impacting body was a dense iron meteorite. Yet, if you plug in the velocity of such a feature, it creates a crater which is 162 meters too deep. This caused some scientists to propose that potentially a small comet formed Colonia Crater instead. However, plugging in numbers for such a hypothetical also largely doesn't work due to comets generally impacting Earth at a far higher velocity due to their origin when compared to asteroids. I thus propose that instead, a slightly oblong dense iron-nickel asteroid fragmented during atmospheric entry, causing multiple smaller pieces to impact the ground within a kilometer of each other. Regardless, we are not exactly sure when this major impact occurred. Estimates range anywhere from 5 to 25 million years ago, and I tend to agree with a younger than 8 million-year-old estimate. When this collision occurred, a 150-meter or 492-foot-wide iron-nickel asteroid collided with our planet at a velocity of around 17 kilometers per second or 38,000 miles per hour. Such a collision created a powerful explosion, releasing energy equivalent to the simultaneous detonation of 431 million tons of TNT, excavating a vast crater. This would have generated a magnitude 6.4 earthquake, and due to the intense thermal radiation, everything within a 26-kilometer radius would ignite, while everything within an even larger 46-kilometer radius would receive a burn on the side facing the blast. An initially 6,700-mile-per-hour shockwave would race outwards from the impact site, losing its energy fairly quickly, but flattening all vegetation in a 45-kilometer radius. Further damage would occur to trees up to 75 kilometers from the epicenter. If further studies are to be made to determine the exact age of Colonia Crater, I suggest that they be performed fairly soon, as new homes continue to pop up inside its crater rim. As a final note, I would like to thank my patron Nathan Myers for upgrading their Patreon membership tier to this channel.